Yo, what's up? It's Paintcustoms. Just coming at you with a video here. I was at my comic store the other day, the one that I usually go to, and I talked to the guys, and they said they had some extra boxes of like fodder and shit, right? You know, because I do customs. And yeah, so the dude's like, yeah, we got a bunch of boxes, and they finally took them out for me. And I mean, I was a little disappointed it wasn't Legends or like Universe or whatever, right? But what it was like a bunch of rare old toys. And like, none of you guys know this, but I'm a huge Star Wars geek. Like, vintage Star Wars is where it's at. That's where I started, like, basically toy collecting, other than when I was a kid, like, having toys. But like, yeah. So, I mean, I got every Star Wars toy, so I mean, my toy identification, I guess you could say, is pretty high. Used to read a lot of toy magazines and just lots of shit, like stuff like that none of us would collect, like dinky cars and like Tinker Toys, shit like that. I learned about, you know, the value of that stuff, so it was good. So it felt like American Storage Wars and whatever, you know, American Pickers or whatever the fuck it's called. And I found a bunch of random, like, cool shit, and I'm looking to sell it. Hopefully I'll make a good buck, or at least break even. I really went in just to buy pieces for my articulated comic book art display that I finally am going to do. But so yeah, pretty much what this video is going to be is me unboxing. It's this box and that box over there I got. So I paid $85. But I know right away that it was worth it for some of the shit that I found. So we're gonna go through this together, and hopefully you guys like it, you know. And if you want to buy any, please buy some of it. All right, word.
Now, here's a little story I got to tell about three bad brothers you know so well. It started way back in history with that rock and me.
My team!
Been had a little horsey named Paul Revere. Just me and my horsey and a quart of beer. Riding across the land, kicking up sand. Sheriff's boxes on my tail.
Right on, so you guys might remember these. These are Planet of the Symbiotes toys. I remember when I was about, I don't even know how old it was, whatever. I was a kid, and Spears had these, and I was really, really stoked on them. Specifically this one. This is the one I had to have for Christmas. Really cool toy. I'm just going to show you here. Yeah, his head's pop out like that, and shit like that. The sculpt's awesome, though. I mean, really, one of the better early Toy Biz sculpts. Articulation is crap, but I mean, like, frankly, like, with the head like that, and teeth, and everything, just looking so good, like, I really thought that's how a Venom should be, like that big, and there wasn't a toy like that. So it was my chance to get a hands-on a Venom toy. And back then, honestly, that regular Venom toy in the Spider-Man series was too hard to get. And then secondly, here we got Riot. This is what I got in the lot. This is actually kind of rare. He's got launching arms there. Kind of do a little launching arm action here. Let's see if we can do it. Bam! So yeah, it's pretty cool. He shoots his arms. Really awesomely articulated, though, this toy. I mean, as opposed to the Venom toy, you know, you can see there he's got articulation in the knee, and then he's got articulation down there, similar to this other symbiote toy I do have. So, yeah, really, really fucking cool. I like that. I do have the original symbiotes, the wall-crawling symbiotes. Now, what's really crazy about this, so I'll open it up for you guys. I mean, take a look. They've never been played with, and I lost mine, and yeah, it's kind of lame, but they're really, really cool, man. Like, they're like these little Venom symbiotes that you get that you can, like, ooze your characters with, and I found, I think, three or four of them in this lot, which is awesome. So, I mean, it completes that dude and that dude. Yeah, just really, really awesome. I'm really happy about this find, so... Yeah, I hope you guys remember that, but also these are for sale as well. I'm going to do a video with some symbiotes, do like a kind of a symbiote invasion thing going on, so hopefully you guys like that. Alright, so I just reloaded my vaporizer, I'm good to go. You guys might know what this is, looking up at the top. This is actually pretty fucking randomly rare. I was going through this box, and like it was just, you know, just parts and accessories, and I didn't know what a lot of it was. Because every goddamn He-Man toy I had as a kid didn't have any fucking accessories. So, you guys should really help me out and let me know whether the He-Man accessories are worth quite a bit. Because I know with Star Wars, like, accessories are the tits. Like, you need accessories or else your shit's fucked. Every comic store I go into and see He-Man toys, they don't have any accessories. So, just to kind of go off here, I figured out with what a lot of these are. A lot of them I don't know, but I have identified them all as He-Man toys, except that tiny little silver sword there and that pink gun. But everything else is a He-Man accessory, like that red gun, that's Many Faces gun, then we got a bunch of the crossbows for the dudes who carry crossbows. This sword I'm not 100% too sure about, but it's a double sword, and it splits apart into two. I know it's very the same as a He-Man sword and the Faker sword, but they go together. I got some parts for Trapjaw here. I actually even have another piece that I just found, his claw. So we got his gun, his claw, and his belt. Beastman's armor. We got some shields here. We got a bunch of other pieces here. Swords, axes, chest armor. Huge. We got Battle Cat's headgear. This is actually pretty cool. His name's Webster from the Masters of the Universe series, and that grappling hook, everything, no knots, no tangles, nothing, completely mint. All these chest armors as well. Now over here, which you may not be able to see, this is 100% original He-Man gear. So you got a sword, his axe, his chest bandolier, and his shield. The cardboard is not wrecked at all. And then we have Skeletor original 1981 pieces, the staff, the loincloth, the sword, and there's another purple sword that I believe they used for him later on. It could have been another character. Crazy. Oh yeah, by the way, this stuff too. I've got a lot of the guns, but also I have all the Castle Grayskull accessories. Where did that come from? We got like the practicing ram. We got the fucking weapon rack with all the weapons. I got even the little gun. I got those guns. The shield, the axes, the clubs, the maces. I know there's probably some other ones that go with that, like this brown axe and such, but like I'm just not too sure yet. The flag with the actual flagpole, and this is super rare too. Just knowing how toys go, usually the more flimsy things you lose, or the paper things get wet. So that's the cardboard cutout of the weapons display from Castle Grayskull. Also, what was in the box is an original attack track from Masters of the Universe, and that was pretty sweet to find. Completely working order. All the parts are there. At first it was missing one of those things, but they just pop off and pop back on, and really, really cool. So tell me what you think about it. Oh, there's also a Modulk. That's 100% complete. Now that's a really hard figure to find complete. There's every single part. I put it together the other night, but it falls apart so easy. Every single piece, both heads, all the torsos, all the tails, all the midsections. It was kind of like a Master of the Universe custom that you could do yourself. Hopefully it'll fetch a good dollar. So if you guys are interested, if you guys are Masters of the Universe nuts and you just need this stuff, please contact me, PM me, message me, whatever. This is all for sale. That's why I bought it. So please get back to me. I don't really collect Masters of the Universe. Okay, cool. So up next, you guys probably recognize what this stuff is. Ghostbusters, Proton Packs, and fucking Ghost Snare. So that's what that is. More of the folk, I mean, I got these for a dude who, on Figure Realm, who really wanted Proton Packs, and I mean, like, who wouldn't? Like, I lost all mine as a kid, and, you know, frankly, if he doesn't want them, I'm gonna put them on my Ghostbusters, and they're gonna have Proton Packs, and they're gonna be able to fight ghosts, and it's gonna be effective. But, yeah. So we got ghosts, though. This was pretty cool. These are actually rare. Like, I've learned a little bit about Ghostbusters toys, and there is a market for them. People are collecting them these days. But the thing is, these ghosts are actually hard to find, because a lot of time, you know, a Ghostbuster would come with these ghosts, and I don't remember having any of these as a kid, but all the Ghostbusters came with them. So a lot of kids didn't even, like, realize they were in the package, because they were too fucking bent out of shape on the toy to even notice. That's the ghost from Ecto-1, so if anyone's a Ghostbuster collector and they're missing that, that's cool. But yeah, I got a couple there, so. Also, we got, I got a Swamp Thing accessory that I needed to complete my set. And yeah, it's just a bag of like random accessories. These are from Planet of the Symbiotes. It was like little balls. But yeah, tons of like Ninja Turtles and different stuff accessories there. Foot Soldier, going out to Blue Devil. Gonna take a head cast of that and then make a NECA style one. So that's that chapter. Cool, so I figured I'd start off kinda with the, 80s to, you know, mid-present. Robotic kind of toys that I found in there. I know you guys are looking at it right away. I'll get to it right away. But yeah, so this is Starcom by Coleco. I remember seeing these at a friend's house. He had these fucking toys, and I thought they were cool. So I'll show you kind of what this one does. It's not, there's no battery, but I mean, they kind of like, you know, knocks the dudes out of the place, but, you know, and they had magnets on the bottom of their feet. So if you guys don't remember this, these dudes had magnets on the bottom of their feet, so they had little battle stations and shit. So, I mean, I'm trying to find out the value of these things, but, you know, whatever. Like, if I get a couple bucks for it, that'd be awesome. Really, really cool. All the stickers are... It's one thing about these toys. All these toys were, like, pretty much preserved in, like, a time capsule. Like, these boxes in the bottom of, like, a huge comic store in Winnipeg here. And the dude finally just took them out. So, realistically, I was pretty stoked on finding them. A couple other things here. Maybe you guys can help me with these. I think they're GoBots. Like, they're not Transformers. I do remember this dude from when I was a kid. I had this one when I was a child. So I'm assuming they're GoBots because my parents were cheap. So, yeah, it's like a little forklift that's intact. And then there's this, it's a pullback race car, but it's also like a Transformer. Okay, cool, fine. We'll talk about this one. So we got Slag from G1 Transformers. It's intact. It's completely perfect, frankly. All the stickers are great, not peeled, not repros or anything like that. Everything looks fucking primey. There's no chips, there's no scratches, there's nothing. So I got that. I noticed that right away. And before the guy offered me a deal, you know, he was saying, you know, buy this, I'll give you this extra box for $20. So I didn't find too much extra crazy shit, but hey, like, Slag, you know, G1 Slag. Or whatever, man. Like, I, you know, in the end, I don't know what that's worth. Maybe you guys can actually shoot me some PMs with what that's worth, or just comment and say what it's worth. I'm not too sure. I'm looking to sell it. If one of you guys needs it or whatever, that's cool too. But I'm looking to sell it in the store here in Winnipeg. And then we got a Beast Wars Grimlock, complete with the tail and everything, like the tail gun that spins. And I've kind of looked that up on eBay, and it looks like that one's worth something. So maybe you guys can help me out with that one too. These are the pre-Marvel Legends that I got in that toy lot. So take a look at these. See if there's anything you guys need for your own collections. Or for any customs if you need any head casts or whatever. These guys are pretty cool. Some AOA stuff. Original X-Men stuff. Cyclops. Rex. All that stuff.
We stepped into the windy at a